I watched every Spider-Man film in preparation for Spider-Man No Way Home, and I'm going to review and rank every single one of them. Keep in mind, I've seen all these already, but it was the summer the last time I watched them, so my opinions have changed a lot. Spider-Man 2002. Now, I do think a lot of people do have nostalgia for this film, but I still think it's an 8 out of 10. Loved it a lot. I think the costume design is on point. Really, really brilliant costume design. I think, obviously, the CGI does need a little bit of an update, but as the story goes, it was like your classic superhero origin story, and it worked really nicely in the first act of Peter learning his powers. And Green Goblin, I thought, is probably one of, if not the best Spider-Man villains we've had. I really like his whole battling with the two alter egos. Really liked all that stuff. And yeah, everyone loved this film. It's Spider-Man. Do I need to tell you why it's brilliant? No, because you already know.
You do too much. You're not Superman, you know.
Spider-Man 2. Now, everyone would say that this is top 10 superhero movies, and obviously, you know it is. Everything with Peter Parker is absolutely brilliant in this film. He just handled it so well, and it really shows, like, the responsibilities of Spider-Man, and shows that really, really well. And along with that, Doc Ock is a brilliant villain. Like, again, one of the best Spider-Man villains that we've ever had. Everyone is just brilliant in this film. The action and stuff is all amped up as well. J. Jonah Jameson is brilliant. J.K. Simmons killed it. Whenever he's on screen, I just get so excited when I see him, because he's just so brilliant. This movie is so brilliant. Everything is amazing.
Let's see who's behind the mask.
Spider-Man 3. Now, obviously, this is a downgrade from both films, but I can find some enjoyment out of it. I know a lot of people really, really despise this film, but I don't know, I kind of like it. Yes, there's like 4 or 5 storylines rolled into one film, and yes, they all did need like their own film to flesh them all out, but I don't know, it was all right. I think they overdid it in the first and second act, but that third act was a really, really good end to the trilogy of four. It did run out of everything very well and was actually quite rewarding. But the butler who told Harry that Norman's wound was from his own, blade, couldn't he have told him that sooner? Like, I'm sorry, you've had 2 films tell him this. Like, come on. Like, this whole Harry situation could have been avoided if you just told him that. But, yeah, it's all right.
Remember Ben Parker?
What does it matter to you anyway?
Everything!
The Amazing Spider-Man. I did prefer Andrew Garfield's Spider-Man to Tobey Maguire's, but I preferred Tobey Maguire's Peter Parker to Andrew Garfield's. This movie was actually really, really good. I liked the origin story, the lizard was decent, and I just think Andrew Garfield's Spider-Man and also Gwen Stacy really just amped this up. The cinematography is also definitely better, and the action has also been very much improved. It's just a very fun watch, and I think that they got the origin story of Spider-Man very, very well.
I am issuing an arrest warrant for the masked vigilante known as Spider-Man.
Okay, here comes the controversy. The Amazing Spider-Man 2. I'm not going to say that this is the best Spider-Man film by any means, but it is way, way, way better than anyone else has said, and it is a very, very, very good movie, in my opinion. Let me tell you why. The villains are just dreadful. Harry Osborn, Electro are just awful. Like, seriously bad. But all the Peter Parker and Spider-Man stuff is beautiful. Like, seriously, is really, really, really good. That is what I absolutely loved about this movie, is him diving into his past, him and Gwen's relationship, just Spider-Man being Spider-Man, just everything to do with that was just fantastic. Like, it was seriously awesome. Just everything with Spider-Man, everything they did was brilliant. But the villains were awful. Like, awful, awful. Now, we can all agree that this is the best cinematography of a Spider-Man film. But, yeah, I actually thought that this was way better than anyone else has said, just due to that Peter Parker and Spider-Man stuff. But I will agree, the villains are seriously bad.
I'm coming with you.
Fine, it's too dangerous.
Sorry, I love you. Don't hate me.
Peter! Spider-Man Into the Spider-Verse, you already know, is absolutely amazing. Everything with Miles Morales is just so cool. We go really deep, and I like all the themes of what it means to be a superhero. The scene where Peter, you know, tells him that can you turn invisible on command and stuff, and then he can't, and he goes away and is able to. It's just wow, it's just amazing. The animation style is so unique. It's like a comic book. It's amazing. Along with the cinematography, it's stunning. It is beautiful to watch. The score, the music is brilliant. When the Prowlers reveal, watching it, you know, I know Prowlers, Miles Morales' uncle. I know Spider-Man. I know that's his uncle. But it just the way it happened, the music, the lighting, everything was perfect in that scene. And it just sends chills all up my body every single time I watch that scene. Spider-Man Into Spider-Verse truly is one of, if not the best, Spider-Man film ever made. It is just some of the villain stuff with Kingpin. I like his motives of obviously trying to get Vanessa back and stuff. But maybe 10 or 20 minutes added onto the runtime to flesh him out a bit more would have been nice. Just made him a bit more of a stronger villain. And this movie would be probably perfect in my eyes.
How am I supposed to save the whole world?
You can't think about saving the world. You have to think about saving one person.
Spider-Man Homecoming. Now, a lot of people would say that Tom Holland is the weakest Spider-Man, and I would say yes, he's probably the weakest Spider-Man and Peter Parker, and even the Iron Boy Jr. stuff does kind of annoy me. It didn't really bother me, but now watching all the Spider-Man films in order, pretty much on a binge, I can say yes, I don't really like it. I think as an MCU movie, this really, really works. You watch this in an MCU binge, it's amazing. As a Spider-Man movie, it doesn't hold up because it is a lot like the MCU. Saying that Vulture is brilliant, brilliant villain. In like, he's like the second best, I'd say, so far. Absolutely loved him. And Michael Keaton as well really did shine. Tom Holland did really well. There's a lot of cool stuff they can go, obviously, with Prowler. Love to see if they extend Prowler a bit more in the future. Obviously, it's game with Scorpion. There's a lot of cool ideas. But, yeah, Iron Boy Jr., there was, like, he was just figuring out his suit. He should already know. There are some great opportunities in there. But, I mean, you know, as a Spider-Man film, it isn't amazing. But I still think it's 8 out of 10. I still really liked it.
Psst, don't do anything stupid.
I got this.
All right?
Yeah.
Venom. Now, I'm struggling of things to say about this movie, so I guess I'll start off with this Venom character is obviously better than the one we got from Spider-Man 3, but this movie isn't absolutely amazing. It feels like just a very generic action movie with just the generic action scenes. You know, you've got the superhero or supervillain or whatever versus like the military or whatever, and then you've got the car chase. You know, the villain Riot is very weak, there's not anything to him. It's really, really just very basic and bland. But I mean, I like the dynamic between Eddie and Venom. I'm gonna like to explore that in Venom Let There Be Carnage, because Let There Be Carnage is the only film I haven't watched so far, so I'm excited to check out that later on. But I mean, it was, the action was very, very cool, but you had the massive CGI action scene at the end, which, I mean, it looked quite cool, but it was just a massive CGI just fight. So there is some stuff I'd like this to go and Let There Be Carnage. Don't know if it will, but yeah, it was okay.
What the hell are you?
We are Venom.
Venom Let There Be Carnage. Now, I've watched this for the first time just a minute ago, and I mean, it's over before it starts. I like the bond between Venom and Eddie. I said I liked that about the first one and wanted it explored more, and I guess it was. Shriek was a bit underused. She was just kind of there. Carnage was okay, although he should have really just kicked up Venom. I mean, there's no way Venom should have won that, but anyway, Carnage, he was decent. Like, he wasn't amazing or anything, but he was just decent. I mean, yeah, this film, I don't know whether it was better than the first Venom or not. I feel like they're on the same level as, like, they're good fun to watch, but when you sit and think about it, they're not as memorable as you thought whilst watching.
Oh, wow!
You could just say, I'm happy for you.
That was going to be us!
I am happy for you.
No!
God, I'm so sorry.
Not sorry!
There's two in some serious couples now.
Spider-Man Far From Home. I am so, so conflicted on this, because one side says it's better than Homecoming because it was such a fun watch and Mysterio was a good twist. That's what that side is saying. It's also saying, like, the action's cool. He's not very Iron Boy Jr. anymore. But then the other half is saying the Mysterio twist was dumb, it was stupid, it ruins the whole Tony thing. You know, it's just really dumb. You just want to see Mysterio as he is. So I'm really, really conflicted. I'm gonna probably say it's better than Homecoming, just because it was more fun to watch than Homecoming. But, I mean, I am so conflicted on it.
I gotta get you guys out of here! Get on the jet!
Who are you?
I work with Spider-Man.
You work for Spider-Man?
I work with Spider-Man, not for Spider-Man. New plan!
And with that is everything I have to say about the movies. But it's time for the ranking. So number 10, I'm going to go Venom. Number 9, I'm going to go Venom, Let There Be Carnage. Number 8, I'm going to go Spider-Man 3. 7, I'm going to go The Amazing Spider-Man. 6, I'm going to go with The Amazing Spider-Man 2. And kicking us on to our top 5 is going to be Spider-Man Homecoming. Number 4 is going to be Spider-Man Far From Home, although that might change soon because I'm just so conflicted on it. Number 3 is going to be the OG Spider-Man Tobey Maguire film. Number 2 is going to be Spider-Man 2. And number 1 is going to be Spider-Man Into the Spider-Verse. And I expect Spider-Man No Way Home to take their number one spot, because I'm pretty sure I'm going to love this film. This looks amazing. Everything about it seems to be so cool. We're going to see the return of so many classic cool villains. I am so excited for this movie. And with that said, don't spoil the movie for anyone who hasn't seen it. And I will see you after Spider-Man No Way Home.
It's all my fault. I can't save everyone.